library once stood, you'll now find nothing but green space. That's because in 2005, the school was closed due to contamination that came from the Langs' chemical plant across the street. Recently, the school was demolished.
If the Hitchin School was contaminated, why was not the village of Addiston, where it sits, contaminated? Why were not the citizens who live here 24/7, 365, their homes and properties, the babies and the elderly, why weren't we listed in that contamination?
The Addiston mayor is asking those questions and more of the EPA and the Ohio EPA in a letter he recently sent them. He points out in the letter that the Three Rivers School District received a $25 million grant to build new schools, partially as a result of extreme environmental contamination at Hitchin's. He also points out the EPA and OEPA received close to $3 million in penalties and fines from Langs'. Steve Young's lived in the village all his life.
The EPA and all of them's got a nice settlement out of this, is what I've heard. The school's got a nice big settlement out. What about the people down here ain't got nothing out of it?
The residents of Addiston did get something out of this deal. Trees. The village was included in a $50,000 ODNR tree grant to plant trees all across the Three Rivers School District. But in this situation, the mayor says trees are a slap in the face. Originally, the chemical company was owned by Monsanto, then it was Langs' and now INEOS. After a number of accidental chemical releases at the plant in 2005, EPA tests determined that breathing the pollution in the village air for 30 to 70 years might give people health problems. With that guideline, the mayor and others want to know what was so serious the school had to be closed.
People never had any concerns until they all of a sudden come in here on a spur of a notice and shut the school down because of the pollution. Okay, the EPA shuts the school down. Why hasn't the village been took care of?
Mayor Dan Pillow says the school system also received a non-settlement of $750,000 from the chemical company. So what's he want for the village?
We would certainly hope that they would do the same thing they did with the school. Maybe they want to buy all the houses in Addiston.
A spokeswoman for the Ohio EPA in Columbus tells me they did not shut the school down. That decision was made by the school district. EPA determined there were air pollution violations. They imposed sanctions against Langs', saying the company, as well as the air quality, have both improved dramatically since. The spokeswoman also tells me that in 2006, when all of this came up, it was explained to village officials that there is no mechanism in place to transfer fines and penalty dollars collected by the EPA to an entity like the village. She also says that she was unaware of any document where EPA called the pollution extreme environmental contamination.
It's fascinating.